Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how to call a process from another process in Process Builder in Salesforce Lightning Experience. Before starting, if you wish to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video and there you will find various links of playlist related to Salesforce videos. So you can follow them as well. Now I'm going to tell you this scenario. So first of all, you need to open the Process Builder where you can create processes. So click on new and here put a name for the process. So name of process is test process. And here you can see this label, the process starts when. So you might have seen this thing like it's invoked by another process. So I think you might not have any idea how it works. So I am choosing this one. And mostly we choose this one, a record changes. So it works whenever a record is created or edited. But if you want to call a process from another process, then you need to choose this one. So this test process will be called by another process that will be created in the Process Builder. So that's why I chose it's invoked by another process. So I'm clicking on save. So here you can see the label test process in bracket. You can see it is mentioning invocable. So you can, this process will not be executing directly. You need to call this process into another process, then only it will be executing. Then we need to choose the object. So let's say I am choosing account object. And here you need to read this. This process starts when another process invokes it. Select an object to associate with the process. Now this help text is also important. So the object you select here determines which other processes can invoke this process. For example, if you select account, you can invoke this process from an account process or a contact process because the contact object includes account ID. So I hope you understood now this thing. So if you are choosing account, so this process can be called through another account object process or contact object process, right? Apart from those, any other object process will not be able to call this process. So I'm clicking on save. And also you might have noticed here, created and edited options are not available. So you can just select a particular object. Then here you need to put the criteria. So let's say I'm putting always run. So I want to execute it always whenever it will be called. So I'm saving this and this sub process will be creating an opportunity. So I'm selecting create a record, choosing create opportunity. Then here I need to put opportunity as record type. Now here I need to fill these details. So for date, I'm choosing a formula where I'm putting today. Use this formula. Then name, so name will be a field reference. So that will be equivalent to account name. So whatever account name will be, same opportunity name will be. Then stage, let's say prospecting. Then I don't want to put forecast category. I just want to put account ID so that this opportunity will be linked with an account. So here I need to put account ID. So whenever this opportunity record will be created, automatically account ID will be populated on that opportunity record. So this way I created this process to create opportunity. So this is an invocable process that can be called by another process. So I'm clicking on activate and confirm. So this test process is created now. So I clicked on view processes. So here you can see this test process is available and it is invocable, right? Now I'm going to create one more process. So this is account process and it will starts when a record changes. So here I am choosing account as object. So here you can see both the options are available. So I'm choosing account record when a record is created. So I'm clicking on save. So whenever this account record will be created, this process will be executed, and I want to run it always. So that's why name is always run and criteria is no criteria, and I'm clicking on save. And for this immediate action, so now you have the option here, like you can choose this processes. So as you click on this processes, so all the invocable process related to this account object will be available in this list. So name is account invocable process, and here so I did a refresh, so that test process is available now. So if that is not available, so you can refresh your screen, so that will be that process will be reflecting. So account invocable process, name is test process, and here you can see it need a reference. So here I am passing current account record that started your process. So I'm choosing first option so that it will be linked, and I'm clicking on save. So whenever you will be creating account record, this process will execute, and internally it will be calling this sub process that we created as invocable process. So now you might be thinking why we did so. So the benefit is, if you have multiple processes, like you have two account processes, and in both you want to use that sub process. So you can create it once and you can use it into more than one processes. Now, if you want to change, if you want to do some changes in this invocable process, so you need to change it once, and it will be reflecting its changes into all the processes where it is called. So this is the basic use of this sub process, right? So whenever you want to reuse any process into more than one processes, so create it as a process and call it through a process immediate action. So this way we created two processes. Now I am activating this. So you will see both the processes are available in the process builder list, and both are activated. So I'm going here. So this is the account process, which will initiate when record changes. And this is the test process, which is an invocable process. So this way I created both the processes. Now I'm going to create a new account record, and you will see opportunity record will be created automatically. So test account process. So this is the name of account. So with same name, an opportunity record will be created. So in the related list, you can see test account process, this opportunity is created. So name of account record is test account process, and name of opportunity record is same as test account process. And if you go to details of this, so here you can see close date, stage, name, and account name. All things are populated, which we provided. So this way, I hope you understood how we can call a process from another process in Process Builder in Salesforce Lightning Experience. So whenever you want to reuse any process, so that whenever you want to change that process and you want those changes to be reflected wherever it is called, so you can use this demonstration, which I demoed you. So create multiple separate processes, and you can link them by calling one by another. So I hope you understood the process action that is available in the Process Builder. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video, and you can find various links related to Salesforce playlist. So you can follow them. Thank you for watching this video.